You're now locked onto the Pulse Radio Show with Marcus Myers, Xtina, and Ken Pyle. And on the one and twos, Big Red the DJ. It's the Pulse Radio Show, baby. Believe that.
Right, it's got a pop-up.
So naturally, you know, with the Pulse, we have guests every week, you know. We dig in, we find out, we dig into the matter.
Yeah, dig into the meat, dig into the, you know.
The meat
of things, right? And we have a very special guest. Somebody ever said that if you didn't know who she was last year, you gotta know she this year, because she's on this ascension to some place that we don't know. I can't even quantify what her success is, but we're gonna find out tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, welcoming for the first time to Pulse, we have Chrissy D.
Hey.
Oh, give me some more dog, please.
There we go.
You are one of the few people that have made the finals in Party Monarch.
It is true.
How do you feel?
Man, I think I'm still dreaming at this point. So probably by the end of July 29th, then it will sink in.
Yeah.
Didn't get there yet.
Did you imagine that you would have gone through?
I felt it, but I wasn't sure, because I always like to leave room for disappointment. So I'm saying maybe, but you know, all things just happen.
Well, that's not good though.
But me in this industry, you gotta tell yourself things just happen.
Yeah, I missed it. Seriously.
So tell
me about the season otherwise.
The season has been amazing. Before everything started, before I even released my music, I told myself I'm making sure that by the end of this crop over, if you didn't know Chrissy D before, you definitely know me now. And I can officially say, when I tell people that I'm Chrissy D, they go, "Oh yeah, I know you," instead of, "Huh?
What you sing?"
So that being said, how long have you actually been doing this?
I've been singing from 2012. I was Olivia, and then I changed my name to Chrissy D later on.
So Olivia is your real name?
Olivia is my middle name.
Oh, I'm Chrissy.
Christina.
Christina
Olivia.
So,
really?
So, in the event that Chrissy don't work out, your last name gonna work.
That's great though.
All of a sudden you see Dottie come up. Okay, great, that's good though. All of your songs. All of your songs though, I saw that Juan Wayne was getting a lot of hype. Would you have said that was the one you were seeing as the main song for this season?
I was. Even when the Sweet Soca results, I kept saying, "I ain't getting competition, man." Mm. And I see Sweet Soca, I was like, "Wait, I ain't getting." Oh, they get party. They run my pace. But you know, things happen. The song that you least expect tends to be the one that, you know, runs stuff in the end.
You said Ramon Bass for everything though. You said Ramon Bass?
Honestly. That was my exact response, because out of all three of my songs, because it's One Wine, Islander, Ramon Bass, I was not checking, I wasn't even pushing Ramon Bass, is the honest truth. But that's the one that people turn out to like in the end.
You know what's interesting? We're getting a trend from artists that they don't exactly understand what it is that the judges want. Would you say that you are in that group of people too, or you understand a bit what they are looking for in criteria?
Man, I don't know what they're looking for. This
is very sad.
It's the truth, because even though my thing is, judges are human. Mm. So even though there's a criteria on the paper, what they circle or what they tick might be
different. There's subjective influences and stuff like that too. So.
Right.
Whatever happens.
Yeah. That's good, very good. So from here now that you're seeing that you have this success and stuff, and you didn't even anticipate it was gonna come, etc., what do you say is your next step?
Well, my next step from here is to make sure that I leave my mark in 29th. I'm going to make sure that by the end of the night, we'll say, yeah, though, that girl hard. Regardless of where it plays, they say that Chrissy D was hard. And then from there, I can just keep the ball rolling, so 2019 will be even better, and I'll get better and better as the years go by.
Who's your biggest competition you would say on the 29th?
Honestly, the reason why I say that, right, is because I strongly believe you could be the best person, but things happen. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So I just go with an open mind because like somebody could be best, and wake up with a sore throat, and then it bursts the tail. Yeah. It's like anything can happen.
Right, true.
So I'm just gonna go and do my best, and then you'll see how it goes.
Agreed. I get you.
So tell us about this song that we have here, One Wayne. Who produced this one?
One Wayne was produced by Anderson Blood Armstrong, Renner Records.
So this is on Blood's album?
Yeah, it is. Nice. It is. So the concept of this song, you know, I wrote it on behalf of a friend. An invisible friend.
You wrote it on behalf
of a friend. That's what I'm gonna stick with.
Lord.
So, it's a girl who pretty much says she doesn't want to do relationships anymore. She just wants to do a one-time.
Oh, a friend.
Yeah, a friend.
Like asking for a friend.
Asking for a friend. Perfect.
I got you.
A friend.
I got you.
So she didn't want to do relationships anymore, and she just wanted to get into the fet. And do a one dance. And the reason why I use one wine, men, I hope you're listening. If you're not a girl's man, don't stay behind her for like six dances. Like,
oh, they got dance limit.
I'm gonna fall out of this chair nodding. I see you, Christina.
We can't each other.
Wait, I want to ask Christina a question.
Wait, which one?
I did that purposely. Oh, no.
I did that purposely.
Oh my god.
Breathe.
So, deep breaths. There is a dance limit, and you will feel the nudge, or you see just walk away from you pretending as though she got something else to do.
They walk forward.
Or lean over to a friend, pretend a conversation.
I came back.
And then you never come back.
And never
see her again. So, wait, someone you know when your time up or
she stops dancing.
She walks forward.
I don't know though.
It happens to you, didn't it?
Last Puff of Color, I danced with a girl, and but I danced with her for two songs, right? Mm-hmm. And then I do these steps.
Where are we counting songs? You only play something
that's count. You gotta do your count song, right? So then I step back, right? But then she stepped back too. So I said, oh, she said, okay. So then we danced about 30 minutes.
She gave you the walk up
and then she still come back for, you know, seconds and thirds.
That means stay. Yeah, that means stay. But if you're dancing on her, she stops dancing, that means stop and move. Mm. Don't keep dancing.
That don't mean try harder?
No, not the first time.
No, that's the first.
We stop first until you are done.
That's the warning.
Yeah.
Warning shot.
And then you get the low.
Very long face, Marcus.
Experiences
because
like,
it has happened to him.
That happened to me at Papa Gala too.
At this Papa Gala. Yeah, I know.
I was dancing on somebody and there was like, she was next to me and she didn't see what she was dancing, so I was like, yeah, I get any mood, eh? And she looked me dead in my eyes. Well, I look back too, I ain't care about nothing. I saw her, I said, where you about? She was like, where you about? And then I had a walk in. That was it, come on.
That was serious for a parent?
Where you about? Well, you both, I get what you mean though. Sometimes you gotta get a warm one. Yeah, sometimes you gotta get a warm one with you. I get you. Anyway,
so,
you were saying.
So yeah.
You wrote the track.
Yeah, I did.
Okay.
I always write my music, you know?
You always do. So are you against working with songwriters?
No, I'm not. I just prefer to write for myself.
Do you think you have a peculiar style that only you can write for or something?
Yep.
Okay.
Yep. Sadly.
So
it's not sad because when I ask people that question, they tend to give me that same kind of response. So I understand what you're saying.
And also it's like, only I know where I'm at mentally. Right. I grow every year. Last year I was singing, Double Tap. And now this year I'm singing One Wine. So it's like, only me know where I'm at. It's for me to write for myself.
Rum on bass, for true. Okay, but yeah, so with Rum on Bass, you did Rum on Bass too.
Yeah.
You wrote Rum on Bass too.
Mm-hmm.
And what was your mind state at that time? Like, we were thinking that there was a certain, like, emotion you wanted to get out, that was your end goal.
You want the honest truth?
Yeah.
I write Rum on Bass for a man to sing though.
Oh, really?
Dude. For a guy to sing, I didn't know who, but then when I put down the demo vocals, which the vocals that are out. I didn't record it.
You did Rum and Bass with Blood as well.
Yeah,
so,
okay. I did. The vocals are out now as a demo. I never recorded song. The man was like, Christine, will you sound good singing this? So keep it. I was like, man, I don't want to sing this song. And Blood looked at me and said, you can regret not singing this song. And I said, all right, fine, I trust you. And now I have Bushy Park when you see himself.
So nice. That's like that. That's
yeah, nice. Probably like people $600 now. I feel guilty.
Okay, so I wanted to ask you some questions. I don't know how much time you have left, right?
Ask the question, big
man. Alright, cool. So we can do it, get to know thing, right? I'm just gonna ask you random questions. Whatever comes to mind, just say, because we want to get to know a bit more about Chrissy.
I scared.
Right? Right. Okay, if you didn't have to sleep, what would you do with your extra time?
Play video games.
Okay, that was easy.
What video games are?
Call of Duty, Second Life, that sort of things.
Alright, cool.
Okay, what's your favorite piece of clothing you own?
My Tim's.
That you wear right
I'm
now?
I'm wearing right now. I love Tim's.
I need some Tim's. How would we look looking, Tim's?
You would look nice in Tim's.
Normal.
You look nice in
oh, yeah.
My last pair of Tim's, I used to wear a pair of Tim's at school, actually.
Oh, you don't wear Tim's anymore?
We all did.
So you got to wear outdated shoes?
I didn't.
That's
because
we all
I looked up to everybody. I was like, oh, you got Tim's at school. How cool. I got on these ugly shoes.
Oh,
I need a pair of Tim's though.
Let me go. Okay, my next question. In the song, I don't know the artist's name, when he says, right now I will beat off saying, what does that mean to you?
Now
I don't do me so boring. No, I don't
know. Hold on. First things first, I am the co-writer of the song. So I definitely can't ask it after you.
Really?
Yeah, I can't ask it after you. I'm sorry.
Wait,
I'm not doing it. No.
What?
Yeah, so I can just leave that.
Wait.
I thought you co-wrote
Beat Off saying?
Yes.
You know that I didn't know that. I just was asking randomly.
Go Koska and check the rating.
Because he's obsessed with the
writer.
That's his favorite song of the year, you know.
Yeah,
first thing when you say Beat Off.
For instance, just means mash up something in another way.
Mash up
that's,
what?
This is why I'm
sticking
with.
What is something?
This is
what sticking,
whatever is in your line. So right now you can beat off a drink. Or beat off some food.
But he doesn't say
beat
food.
Off some homework. Wanna try to carn me off, bingo?
Beat off saying.
What? There's only two things he beats off. It's beat off saying and beat off a thing.
Yeah, beat off.
So what is saying and what is a thing?
Yeah, Chrissy.
Well, in the verse, alcohol is mentioned. And then in the other verse, a bumper is mentioned. So they're your answers.
So beat off a bumper?
Beat off a
listen
bumper.
Listen to me.
That's impressive.
Listen to me.
That's so aggressive.
Well, yeah, it's the song you like though.
Oh my goodness. I just don't understand it. It's just, it's so up for interpretation.
But now what you like.
You need a whole literature course.
The best songs are open. For you to just think whatever you want to think.
Right now, oh, beat off. Whoa, okay, let's move on.
It's just like right now, battery is not included, jugs galore.
Yeah.
Yes. You're really
beat off
like
a thing.
Beat off a thing, I don't
you
know.
Start it right now with this one, man, jugs galore. Battery's not included, right. So he sets the tone for the jugs, and the jugs is the power of the beating.
Yeah, and if you had to see him perform it live, he legit performs it as rough as a song.
So
I love it.
Who is it again? I can't remember.
D2.
D2.5.
D2.5?
Yeah, D2.5 now. Yeah.
D2.5?
Yeah. Change his name.
He's watching fireworks now.
Correct, and also yeah. Tamron Rod show, so that's where the live come from. Facebook Live.
Right.
Bam, bam, boom. There you go. You're welcome.
I just took in so much information at once. I didn't think I was going to go there. I thought we were going to do
that. But I'm really going to gloss over
one
that
quick
one.
Answer. Okay. Do you have any unpopular opinions?
Yeah. A lot. I can't really.
Like, do. You can't think of none off the top.
Pretty heavy question.
Yeah, that's
I like to disagree with people for some odd reason. It's
okay.
Fun.
Okay.
You look so fantastic today.
You disagree?
Nah, I can't disagree with that one. Not as it relates to me, come on.
Okay, what other than any songs that you have co-written or sung or anything, what is your favorite song this season?
I got two. Can you both? Rhea, when she got a song named Best Friend.
Jeez.
Hard show, boy.
Hard.
I like that. Hard.
I got Big on My Best Friend Summer. The Trevor Soka.
Trevor
Soka,
yeah.
Two of them. Yeah.
Okay, two of them.
I actually get that on Romix today.
That Romix mean, bro.
Yeah,
I heard both of them.
Yo, what is the. Do I have any more questions, though? Oh, what's the best thing that happened to you last week?
Oh, I found out that was in Party Manor.
Oh, yeah, great. Yeah. Is there anything else? Oh, and last one, very last one. What hobby would you get into if time and money weren't an issue?
Yeah. Nah, boy. I only the dot music, so just music all the way. I would quit my job and just do music.
Or collecting teams?
Nah, bro.
You would trade any teams to produce another song?
Yeah. To be honest.
You don't like that teams? Give me that, yeah.
No, I love these. But when it comes to music, I can pick music first.
Oh, okay. But I hope that happens because I want some things.
Chrissy, I want to thank you so much for passing through the Pulse Radio Show.
Thank you.
What I'm going to let you know is introduce your track, man, right now, live on the Pulse Radio Show.
All right, sweet. So, guys, right now, you're listening to my 2018 track entitled One Wine. Check it out.